And we're back. Are we back? And we're back. Yeah, we just got back from a hyperspeed adventure, guys. That's that used up all the power in the building, apparently. So
and I accidentally tripped the EMP on accident.
Yeah. I believe that was a purposeful EMP blast.
Maybe.
Yeah, I needed to actually just get a little fan to fan me off then. So sorry for that, guys.
We were discussing
the gem feature. Jewels feature.
Oh, and the costume bonus. Yes, you get the costume bonus.
Yeah.
Regardless of whether it's A or B.
Of course. Let's see. I'd like to get one more question in here before we move on.
The spinny wheel?
For the spinny wheel here, yeah.
Will there be more arena prizes?
Will there be more arena prizes aside from gems? Arena prizes, sorry.
At this moment, no. But we'll, of course, look into expanding that just to make, you know, arena more rewarding, I guess.
And I like
so
it,
it'll
yeah.
entice
more rewards equals more rewarding.
And more players.
I love it. I believe that was Where Garuru, and because of that question, and because of that name...
You will do it.
I will do the
While
spin.
Roaring.
I can't...
Is it a roar
you gotta
growl?
Hold this. You gotta hold this for me, though.
Okay.
All right, here we go. This growl goes out to you.
You gotta keep going until it stops. Five premium summons.
There you go. Five premium summons. The roar helped with the thing though. So, awesome. All right then. I believe.
What's going on, man?
I know. They're like, what is all this? before we take a break though, guys, I did want to one last thing. Like I said, the premium summons now are going to be 24 gems, and I believe it's going to be what?
24 rubies.
24 rubies, and then it's after, because you do get
20.
That discount,
it'll be
right?
Rubies.
So it'll be 20 with additional summons after that, though. So, this update's going to give you a little bit of spend crazy with your gems, rubies.
Gems, rubies, jewels.
We're throwing them all out. Now it's just getting interchangeable and confusing, though, so... I don't know. But don't go anywhere, guys, because when we come back, we're going to do a little bit of an arena guide as well as a labyrinth run up to 40. So with that being said, I need to cool off really quickly. So don't go anywhere. All right, guys, welcome back. Like I said, we're going to get a little bit into an arena guide. Bear in mind, this is catered more so specifically towards a warrior, but some of these tips so that were included by our community member, Sui, I just threw my pen at you, they are playing a warrior, so this is mostly catered towards warriors, but just bear in mind, we do have some other tips. So while I'm kind of discussing some stuff, to not completely bore you, we're going to have Peter just go through some friend battles in the arena. We do kind of have a team comp set up based on the suggestions from Sui. So let's go ahead and run a couple of battles in the meantime. So first, the thing we kind of want to discuss were ally choices for the arena. They haven't registered, that's why.
Let's go with...
Who else is in there?
registering?
Who isn't registering? How dare them?
Nexus.
It's probably just none of those people were registered then. In the meantime, we could just run some normal campaign levels, and then we'll just kind of like talk about it then, because obviously Labyrinth isn't locked. So, but let's go ahead and just talk about allies then to use for the arena battle system. From what we were kind of collaborating with, Graham is still pretty much a universal decision to bring in to arena. You know, with his ability to not only disable but also to stun them. He's just a very valuable asset to the team. Chabelle is also still considered a super valuable pick. Now, the reason we're kind of just throwing out random like story heroes and stuff like that, guys, we realize and recognize that not everybody will have access to the Draco allies. Obviously, those are the best of the best, right? But if you don't have access to those guys, these are still good follow-ups. So Graham, we have Chabelle, who does have her AoE resurrect. Also, Teal is still considered a really valuable pick because of the ability to not only have an AoE stun, but occasionally be able to proc a stun off of auto attacks. So, like I said, it's very, you kind of want to pick a lot of versatility in arena. The more you can stun or control your opponent, the more that you can attack and whatnot. And then finally, rounding it out, another good alternative is Belle. With her ability to, provide an attack and defense bonus. That's always something that's valuable in an arena battle. Now, in terms of DPS, what kind of healer you should bring in, or if you're a tank in general, what kind of healer or helper ally you should bring in? Like we said, someone that can contribute more so to the controlling the battle rather than just nuking DPS down. So if you have somebody like Chabelle to bring in, she is a good alternate to bring in as a helper ally. So someone that can, because I think the big thing about arena is you kind of want to try to sustain as much of that early burst. A lot of people will have their stuns, their sheeps and whatnot. So any ally to either negate that damage or heal up that damage quickly is very, very beneficial. So, and then something else, since we did have a new formation system currently be added in, something that was suggested to us, and at first I was a little hesitant on, but then I did kind of agree on a little bit more, is that Solidarity formation is pretty useful. Now, just because it is the experience buff-wise, though, something that they, Sui made a point of, is that since all the options in there are a normal ally that you can incorporate in there, because normal in the formation system is a bit of like a wild card, so to speak, right? You're not restricted as if, you were to pick a more of a DPS one where it will, restrict your ability to incorporate, we're running two tanks, so, being able to have just those five wild cards to kind of shift around everything, because each individual spot will give, I believe there's two areas for a tanks, as well as they give the stamina bonus, they just give the two stamina bonus. The backline has more evasion bonuses, and then I think two of the other ones in that area have an attack bonus, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
So attack speed or something. Yeah, I think it's one of those two. But like I said, those individual spots, because obviously when you level them up, you can just level those spots to have an increased effect. That seems to be universal. So I think, and it was a pretty interesting choice to kind of look at it like that, in the sense of like the formation itself won't add, but the individual stats will be more beneficial for that. Yes? What was the name of it? Easy wants to know.
We've got a decent build for
SP3. Easy SP3 wants to know the current build that we have. Let's go ahead and show them right now. Yeah. Now, I'm spec'd more so tank because it's something that I find it's more beneficial for that spec to... Oh my god, you got so many. Look at you. Especially since we're going into Labyrinth, it's something that we want to focus more on a defensive spec. So right now we have 5 points in Shield Strike, and then we're going to max out that taunt to get the ultimate taunt. And then... this was up in the air because we wanted to max our physical strength, and then 9 into fighting spirit, So that left about 6 points left. So those are the main ones you want to get. So you want to do 5 into shield, completely max out your taunt, and then 10 into your physical strength, and then fighting spirit, 9. So that'll leave you 6 points. Those are kind of interchangeable. So we basically just did 3 in intensified rage, three intensified rage, and then 3 into sword training. I mean, the decision's up to you. If you maybe want to do a little bit more damage, you can do some more into your, what's it called, Rage Rush. But this seems to be a pretty good spec. And like I said, I know a lot of people are running DPS warriors and stuff like that, but this is more so for a Labyrinth tank run, you know, because the tank or the warriors with a defensive stats are really good in a Labyrinth run. You know, the ability to taunt, shield strike and stuff like that, especially if you're focusing more damage on you and you know what kind of equipment you have.
I mean,
you can
taunt
really
last 18.8 seconds. So yeah. That's really a long taunt.
Yeah, exactly. So, yeah, so I hope this build helps you to kind of overcome Labyrinth runs. We'll kind of show off our Labyrinth runs here too. So, yeah.
Nips Legolas?
Is that
him?
Yeah.
Nips Legolas. Nips Legolas wants to know, what is the best Labyrinth build for warriors and allies to use? So like I said, the build that we just showed off is the most optimal build. Obviously, it's not the most optimal for arena because, you know,
the DPS isn't as high.
Isn't as high in there, but we were just showing off arena stuff. But this is more so catered towards a Labyrinth run. Now, in terms of allies, right now what we're using, so I wanted to incorporate just 2 of the Draco allies in there because, like I said, I know not everyone will have access to all of them. Mm-hmm. So we chose to go with a Bright Spark in our group as well as a Blacaria. And then we followed up with just a normal Bright Spark and then King Graham just because we wanted to have 2 of those frontline tanks. And, you know, Graham contributes a lot of stuns and whatnot because when you get into those high-end, like 28-plus, some of those guys will start attacking really hard in there. So, you know what, Nips Legolas, let's go ahead and give you a spin then for asking about this build. This would be our 4th spin, yes. Spin it for me, baby. Spin it for me. My voice is getting shot. I sound like a pathetic Wookiee now. What do we got?
I think it's going to be a...
It's
200 shoes.
So you get 200 shoes.
Nips Legolas.
Spin
that thing better, man. You bet 2 premium summons, 2
I know.
I agree. I think that's a... He's a scoundrel, man, you know?
the law of averages or whatever. Last time we had a bunch of S to triple S.
I feel like our very last spin will be giving an S to triple S. You know, we got to find balance in the world, and I think that last spin will be it. Right? Sure. Nobody likes shoes. Aww. sorry. Anyway, rounding out our last bit of tips for arena stuff. Formation-wise we already talked about formations in there. Something I did want to comment on is I know a lot of people were asking about, since Blacaria is pretty strong right now, her passive, when she dies, she has 8 seconds of invincibility. Obviously, the counter to a Blacaria is having a Blacaria, but seeing as that might not be possible for everybody, something that me and Nick have toyed around with the idea of and that we kind of implemented last time that we were on the show is that we would wait that 8 seconds after she had died, because then you kind of visibly see she's dead, and then at that point you kind of just wait to blow your cooldowns. Obviously your allies are kind of doing what they do, but you know, if you're like a mage or you know, rogue who has really good AoE, you'll want to wait to, you know, use your cooldowns after that 8 seconds, and then you just pop it, and then hopefully at that point you're alive to, you know, be able to do enough damage to take them out though. So yeah, that's kind of just like a rough little guy to kind of help you guys out in there. In terms of anything else in the arena, you know, we have a great, you know, guides and suggestion forums that people are obviously throwing out as much content and as many theory crafting ideas that are out there. I was reading in there, I think someone was like theory crafting about Graysoul being able to, what's called, disable or debuff that invincibility on Blacaria.
Okay.
I'm not sure if that's been tested or if that's just like some kind of theory that people are throwing out, but I mean, that's stuff that you can guys, you know, test on your own and share with our community and see Maybe there is that hidden gem of defeating Blacaria, though. So, so hopefully this kind of gave you some sort of direction into Arena, but I know you guys want to talk more about Labyrinth, and we'll do that as soon as Pete here destroys everybody. Just wanted to let you guys know that you did a fantastic job with the last update. I am Mule, thank you. Thank you so much, I am Mule. Really appreciate that, and I hope you appreciate how much, how hot I am up here right now in this.
Yeah, they turn off the AC. It's good.
I know.
A little stuff.
It's good, man. We can make it through this. So let's go ahead and do a labyrinth here. So, guys, while we're doing a labyrinth run, we're going to start from level one.
We will be taking in
our allies. So the allies that we will be taking in, we won't be auto-selecting them, so remove all those.
Oh, just kidding.
So we're going to be... we have specifically made a team, guys, for the labyrinth run. Our goal is to get up to level 40 on labyrinth. So if we get up to level 40, guys, we'll be giving out some rewards. So I have them here. If we get up to...
50 and 100.
It's 50, yeah. So 50 shoes if we get up to 30, I believe, right?
40. Or if we don't hit 40.
If we don't hit 40. So if we don't hit 40, you'll get 50 shoes. If we do get past 40, that'll be 100 shoes. Like I said, we've designed a team specifically for this. So we have a... we already have Graham in our party, but we're going to go to... Chabelle. So go ahead and add Chabelle. Yeah.
You said no.
I did say that. And then we're going to add, Byron. Teal.
Teal.
And then finally we're going to add... No. Yeah, Guard. We're going to add Belle as the last ally.
Mercedes.
Or Mercedes, sorry. Yeah. Belle, Snow, Mercedes.
All right.
I get them confused. So, essentially what we're going to do, we're going to start from round one and work our way up. Ooh, do we have scrolls? Ooh, good call, Nick.
Yeah, do
we have scrolls? Tip number one.
Oh, we have.
Bring in scrolls.
All right, so we gotta fill up a little bit.
Yeah, another thing we've worked on with Sui is this labyrinth guide here. Once again, just kind of prefacing that this is more so catered to a warrior build, but you can take some elements in the sense of like DPSs and stuff like that, or the DPS guide. There you go.
Boom, boom, boom.
There you go. Yeah, so
all
we're...
three revival scrolls.
So we're bringing in three revival scrolls specifically because we have some pretty strong healers, but it's mostly because we want to have at least three, revive chances throughout our battles and whatnot.
Shall we begin?
Let's go ahead and start it then. Two tickets.
Boom.
Two tickets to paradise then, huh? All right, so first and foremost, some suggestions we got as far as gear type. Having a four-piece set of the Aqua set, which for the warrior is a 51 plus 51 stamina, as well as having, if you can, getting that two-piece of the Blazing set. I believe some of those pieces that you would want to focus on are the evasion set item chances, because the two-set Blazing will give you 19 immunity and I believe 3,000 HP. Mm-hmm. So that's something you definitely want to try to obtain if you're looking to get into those higher levels. The best stat currently for a tank warrior is you're going to focus on primarily max HP, and then running that up would be immunity and or evasion. And then if you can get defense, stamina, and then strength would be one of the tail end things. Like I said, the reason why it's not more of a DPS build in here is because since the warrior does have a lot more armor sets or armor pieces in his inventory that he can collect, it negates a lot of damage, you know. So, mm-hmm. And then you have your AoE taunt too. So it's he's very good if you have enough gear and if you do spec him correctly. Like we kind of just discussed, the best skill set would be the 10 in your taunt, and then 9 into your six into your stun, and then 9 into your passive fighting spirit, as well as 10 into your physical strength. So with the other six skill points, you can kind of move them around, figure out what else you want to do and whatnot. So now, like I said, kind of discussing. What's up, Nick?
Icecraft has a good question. Hopefully, Peter can answer that.
Okay.
Whoa, I saw that. Okay. How does Sorcerer Theros' totem heals get calculated? I'm assuming. So that would be. We've got one. According to their int?
It's based off of infin?
I'm not sure.
Because I think it has its own. Yeah, I think the totem thing? Itself has its own.
I'll have to take a look at the skill description one more time.
Yeah, because when I originally had him, I thought the orc itself influenced the totem and how much heal it does. Mm-hmm. But what I was told is that the actual totem itself has its own set of stats that take into account or calculate. So I don't know if it's like the stats are influenced by the actual ally or if it has its own set of stats based on how enhanced the ally is.
I actually have a Theros, but...
Do you? I think some theory crafting is in order then at this point, right? let's see. So we already kind of talked a little bit about the different allies that we're currently using. Like I said, Graham being the stun bot that he is, and then we have two of the Draco allies, the Brightspark, as well as Blacaria.
We have not called any of them yet.
We have not, yes. Well, we haven't called any of our helper allies either, so...
Oh, yeah, that's what I meant.
That's what you meant, yeah. I got you. Look, as we're already kind of powering through, I think once it gets to, like, about 26, we might have to take over actual controls, though. Mm-hmm. Now, something I did want to mention, though, before, and this was brought to my attention that I had no idea, because I'm probably just... not very perceptive to this. Yes, go ahead.
So it seems like the viewers are saying the totem heal scales according to the level and the enhanced level.
Boom, what did I say?
Is that what you said?
I said I believe it's based off of either that or the enhanced level.
I don't know, I think you're talking about the totem itself.
No, I thought I said, anyway. Stop
it. I was just testing you guys. I'm glad you guys know the right answer.
So yeah, something I didn't know in here, so we're kind of getting into the 26, we might want to start paying attention here. I'll take control over here. Is that the helper allies, in case you guys didn't know, if they are defeated, you can't actually resurrect them. There is a, I believe, 2-second gap in which when they die, their portrait stays still lit. Mm-hmm. But then after about like 2 or so seconds, they will disappear, or not disappear, but they'll turn red, which means you won't be able to ever resurrect them. Mm-hmm. So if you do resurrect them during their time that they're still up, you'll still be able to resurrect them and heal, and then as their time runs out, you'll be able to use them again after when they come back up. So that's something I didn't realize, though, which is
actually... So when should you use the helper allies?
So we want to do those on
boss stages,
right?
Boss ways, probably.
Yeah, so I think we actually just went through one, so we didn't really need it there. But I believe the boss stages are what, like 39. So I'm not. I haven't gotten past 40. So I'm not sure. Well, I've gotten past 40, mm-hmm. but I haven't gotten past like into the next. Because I thought it went by increments of 5. But who knows? Though. So also the best time to pop your allies are going to be the wave before a boss wave. This wasn't a boss wave, so.
So we're at 32. So you probably want to at the end of 33.
At the end of 33. But I just popped it now because I know that wave wasn't going to be very strong then. So.
Okay.
That's what we do, though.
Oh, at this point in time, no. It will be TatGod91. Will we ever be able to place our allies in specific formation? Or, yeah, I guess Soterra also sent the same. Right now, no. So it's in formations, you have this classes that are set, where you which classes are in that formation. But in terms of specifically placing your allies, let's say there's two tanks, you cannot specifically choose which ally gets into which position. But there is, so they'll be positioned according to like HP or defense. So it automatically calculates according to your ally stats, and then it positions it accordingly.
Nice.
What's going on? Are you dead?
No. So this was another tip, though, brought to you by Sui, is that. I think a lot of people, when they're new to the Labyrinth, will sometimes panic and see that somebody's dead, mm-hmm. and then they'll just waste one of their resurrect scrolls. But it's one of those things, if you have a good enough team that can get by with 4, or maybe you just did it in the middle of a... or maybe they died like at the end of a wave and they, somebody panics and they're like, oh, I want them up, but that's not the case. You don't have to necessarily blow your resurrect scrolls if you don't have to. Mm-hmm. So obviously we have one of the, Draco Brightspark down, mm-hmm. but I still have, my other 4 members that are mm-hmm. still able to maintain. So, I mean, I don't think it's really necessary at this point, though. So, unless somebody else dies, or what you could do is time it in tandem with one. So see, she already got resurrected anyway, though, so I didn't really need to do anything. But what you can do is, yeah, I think I'll be. I'll be fine.
Will we ever be able to pick what class SSS you pull? No, you cannot choose which triple S you will get to summon or combine.
Uh oh.
You're so close.
We're good. We should be.
Oh,
good.
You haven't used any of your Bible scrolls. So
yeah. I'm gonna bring out just in case Mercedes.
When are we gonna be able to equip full set on allies? Right now, there are no plans to expand on what you can equip on allies. So right now, it's just the weapons and armor.
No, I'm not. I'm not timing these res correctly. No. That's good, Byron. I'll see if I can kind of time it and show them how to resurrect here.
Does this new update bring the option to combine skill cards? No. This update brings no changes to skill cards. In the future, there may be updates, changes for the skill cards, but at this point in time, especially for next week's update, there's no planned changes for those.
Yeah, so as you guys see, as you guys saw, I was able to res... Byron, he was dead, and since everyone else was dead with him, it was kind of like a mass res then, so. Round 41, so that means everyone...
Res those babies. Shoes.
So that's what, 100 shoes to everybody. I mean, do you think I should just keep going to see how far I can get? Let's see if we can get to 50. See if we can hit 50. I mean, I have some good resurrect scrolls up. I am a concern, though, because...
Twerking dinosaur.
Huh?
Said your name on stream.
I said your name on stream.
Oh no! Did I open a Pandora's box? You only get one of those per stream, so.
Is that what that is?
No more callouts.
Oh man. Let's see. So I'll probably resurrect right after this. So as you can see here, like my Byron, or Graham and regular warrior, are pretty beefy right now. So it's like, you know, I don't feel the need to really. Unless Graham here falls in, and then I'll probably have to do it, but... Let's see if I can get past this, though, without resurrecting anybody. You think I can?
No.
Yeah, okay. I'll go ahead and do it. Never mind.
Whoa.
Oh, man. All right, 44. It's getting difficult. I still have two scrolls up right now, though. I think I have the power to go all the way...
To level
80? Yeah. To level
80. Infinity and beyond.
It never ends. Oh, no. I am paying attention to the revise. I'm just wanting to time them correctly and not just blow them all. Oh. Well, see, now that you said that. So, rule number two, right?
What?
Well, no. Another thing I was going to suggest is don't do what I just did and resurrect when your taunt is off. Cool. Mm-hmm. Or you haven't used your taunt. Obviously, you want to time as well as your, you know, helper ally getting killed, but you're going to want to taunt before you also do your resurrect scroll, just because, like, the last thing you want to do, which is what I did, is resurrect everybody, not taunt, and then they just get bombarded, you know? So I don't know, man. We're on our way here. Oh, well, and
Graham
I just got destroyed there.
Real powerful over there.
I know, right?
Oh, there, he shrunk again.
Never taunt.
Do you have any recommendations for formations to use in Labyrinth?
Recommendations. I believe I wrote one down, which would be the Noble Chivalry. Just because in the later stages, like we are right now, these guys hit really hard. Mm-hmm. So being able to have two tanks to kind of try to mitigate the damage is really, really beneficial, though. So. Yeah, that would be my go-to stance is Noble Chivalry. Noble Chivalry. Come on, Byron, come off cooldown. No.
Would an all-warrior class be viable for the Labyrinth? I think they may be
an all-warrior comp?
Team, maybe? Yeah.
I mean, only problem with that would be is you wouldn't be able to get any heals.
Yes.
Plus that, it would just seem like a really slow Labyrinth run at that point.
That's
then.
True. I mean, maybe...
Here we go, we're up to 50. We're up to 50. You think I could do it, Pete? You think I could do it?
The Wookiee
war cry. Dude,
if I
oh, no.
No!
You! It was you! Oh, no!
Wookie crying.
I got distracted off camera. That's not fair. Oh, what is that?
It's a split second.
What is that? I don't know how to feel right now. I don't know how.
You did well, though.
I didn't rez because Nick told me to do a Wookie cry, and in that split second, he removed my.
It's okay. So you know, 100 shoes for everyone.
You guys still get 100 shoes, though. I gotta put the hoodie back on, but.
Dang, you are sweating it up.
Hey, you know.
Everyone's like, whoa.
Wookie got wrecked. I definitely Wookie did. So yeah, that was, I almost, that was.
Oh, so close.
I'm assuming that's what a Wookie cry sounds like. I don't know.
All right.
Anyway, so if you guys have any final questions about Labyrinth setups, about, you know, maybe any warrior comps, yeah.
We
do have one more spin, so if you guys have any questions about Labyrinth
He's
and whatnot.
Pretty sweaty.
I am. I mean, I have just these.
Angry Jamaican.
Any advice for a new player using Mage? I am on hard mode.
What do you think? I don't play a Mage. I mean, what are your tips about Mages?
For Mage, definitely try. Yeah, yeah. Especially for the single player, Meteor helps to clear out those the waves really quickly. Mm. And having a tank really helps. I was lucky to get a Byron pretty quickly.
Okay.
And then, because yeah, Mages can be squishy, so it definitely helps if your allies can take most of the damage.
Let's see. Ooh, can taunt. Can taunt warriors ever compete with sheet mages? That's that's difficult. You know, I mean, at that point, I feel like it's like whoever gets their CC off first. You know, I mean, I know whenever I started up,
I totally missed the question.
We think warriors ever be taunt warriors ever be comparable to sheet mages? And it's a tough question because I mean, it's a lot of like you know who can get off there. CC ability first. I know though if you have what's called evasion, I believe evasion takes a plays a part into whether or not that CC lands though. So yeah, I mean it's debatable. So if you can land that taunt, I definitely would try to follow up too with like a stun too with on that mage. But I think primarily you want to focus a lot on like you know healers and like lower end or lower HP. People in there, but I mean, if you're concerned about mages, I would probably try to focus them just with your CC because that's what tank warriors are better at than obviously the DPS warriors. But what's up, Nick?
Just Joshin, yeah, okay. Wants to know.
Will there be an option to skip the quest dialogue?
Yes.
Ooh, I know that
everybody wants to.
Everybody wants.
You guys don't like the story. You don't want
to
read
the four times.
That's true, though, you know.
At this point, no, but we'll definitely forward that to the devs. I mean, that's something, of course, yeah, I can also agree with, just having a skip intro, skip the cinematic stuff.
Yeah. Essence are taking too much place in storage. Yeah, they are. I agree. I have a lot of essences right now just waiting. Waiting. And I want it fixed right now, Peter.
Too bad. Just hurry up and get 10 and,
And just deify. That'll clear up your inventory right away. Yeah. Is it possible to hit a high Labyrinth run without Dracos? And if so, what's a good setup? So I mean, yeah, that's what we try to kind of do with our setup. Obviously, it's difficult. It'll be difficult without a Draco ally because they offer a lot in terms of just you know like the Lucaria offering the immunity and whatnot. And I mean. It is. But I mean, like some of the allies that we showed you, like, you know, Mercedes, Byron, some of those are good alternatives. They aren't the best, but I mean, if you are struggling with getting Dracos, I would probably say something like that. Like, you know, Mercedes, Byron, Graham, if you have him. What else? Teal. I know Khalgar,
the
new Wolf War guys.
Like the offensive priest.
Yeah, so like he like hits people and his wolves do damage and heal in return. So
his wolves.
Those would be pretty good alternatives then. So. Blue eyes. What is that? Blue eyes.
Blue eyes. Super guy.
Super guy.
Is the
wants
priest
to know.
Draco the best one to get first? Well, I think that depends on what you need. Like for me, I got Bright Spark first because, or Blacaria first because I didn't have a AoE healer. Yeah. So I definitely needed a
That's AoE probably going to be my first one too because right now I have just a triple or a double S healer and I'm getting by on it, but it's definitely one of those things that's kind of holding me back in the higher end campaign runs.
But I mean, if you have like Mercedes or Chevelle, I mean, you could go for like Draco Death Crown, you know, a tank.
Yeah. And you know what? Because you're
going to... Or a Graysoul.
Because you want some of those Draco allies, why don't we give Blue Eyes Supra Guys...
Supra Guy.
The last spin for today, then.
All right, you want to do it?
I'm going to go ahead and do it.
Pressure's on you.
I want you to hold this. I'm going to show you how... I'm going to stand up. I'm going to show you how a Wookiee spins this.
I want a real guttural growl. Aren't you going to spin like, at the same time?
Oh, right.
why do you have the water boy face? Doing it?
You're looking at it head on is kind of scary,
actually.
This
one's for
you. Oh!
There you go. Three S's to triple S for Blue Eyes Super Guy. And that's because of the scream, man. I put in the energy.
I'll give you credit for that one.
Whew! That was intense.
Ended on a good note.
It did, yeah. But we're gonna actually take a quick break, though, guys. We'll be back right after this. Alright guys, we are about to conclude today's episode. I need to get out of this costume and fast. But before we do that, just a couple of quick announcements. Excuse me, sorry, I got a raspy voice. Been talking for so long. But for you guys, so you guys did get the 1300 viewers rewards. Bear in mind, we'll probably be sending those out next week. Next Tuesday. We are on holiday, we have Memorial Day. Or
Labor Day,
sorry. We have a day off. We have Labor Day off on Monday,
and
so you guys...
And that's not a coupon code or anything.
Yeah, it's going to be just... Everybody's going to be getting those rewards.
You'll see it in your mailbox.
Exactly. And then, so we did have a little bit of something that we wanted to share with you guys, right? Peter, do you want to take it, or should I just take the reins on this one?
I think you're on a good roll right now.
I feel like I'm on a good roll. So we wanted to give you guys a little bit of a sneak peek. So obviously, this next update is going to include just... The big thing is going to be the jewel system. But... The update after that, though, we wanted to give you guys a little bit of a sneak peek. So with the next update, mm-hmm. we're going to be introducing 2-3. So that means a new campaign is going to be opened up. Mm-hmm. We're going to have an increased level cap. Obviously, with a new zone, we're going to be giving you guys access to new allies, a new raid boss, new sets of items, and something that's we're going to keep kind of secret, a little hush-hush, but... All I can say is that hopefully you guys will find that secret a bit heavenly.
Ooh.
Pen drop. And then one last thing we didn't mention also too, lollipop event. Lollipop event will be ending.
So yes. Get your lollipops before next week.
Yes. I believe that's everything here then, huh, Peter?
I guess so.
Cool. Well, I want to thank you guys for joining us once again. Peter, my partner in crime over here, thanks again. And from all of us here at GAMEVIL, put that thing down. From all of us here at GAMEVIL, guys, thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you in another galaxy.
Punch it, Chewie.
Oh.